Do you like winter and snow? I love it, and that's why I'm going to teach you how to make a pretty good and realistic snowfall in Photoshop easily. The steps are pretty simple. The first thing you do is go select color range. There is this dialog window right here, and with this tool hold shift from your keyboard and select as much of the blue sky as you can. Okay. Now there are some things right here that are selected and we don't want them, so we're gonna take our rectangular marquee tool, hold Alt on the keyboard and simply drag. See, and that removes selection. Oops. Be careful when you do this. Take your time when you do this, if you need to do it. I just need to do it. Oops. Oh, anyway, doesn't matter. And now there's a selection right here, and we're gonna go new adjustment layer, hue and saturation. And there are these options right here. Now load down the saturation, and you see the image is turning gray. Load about right here, and then turn up the lightness, and that is pretty good. Okay, now we're gonna make a new adjustment layer with photo filter, which is right here, and select a cooling filter 80, and these settings are pretty good with 25 at density, and that's pretty good. It depends on you what do you want. Anyway, now we're gonna make a new layer, okay, and fill this whole layer with black color, of course, right here, and we're gonna go ahead and select filter noise, add noise, so the amount has to be around 100%. We're gonna fix that in a minute, don't worry. Select uniform and monochromatic, and because if monochromatic isn't turned on, we'll have these colorful things and we don't want them, so select monochromatic and click OK. Now there are too many of these and that's why we need to get rid of them. So we're gonna go filter blur more. That's the first step, that adds a Gaussian blur, and now we're gonna go to image adjustments levels and turn down the levels around 124, this one, and this one has to be around 262, and this one should be around 176. So these settings are pretty good in my opinion. It depends on you again. Okay, that's okay. And now click OK. Now to get rid of the black background, simply select the layer and set it from normal to screen. But that's not a snowfall yet. Okay, there are a few more steps to go. I'm gonna go filter blur, motion blur. Oops, set the angle around -60. It's up to you basically, doesn't matter. And the distance around 10. And that's pretty good. And we'll fix that, don't worry. And click OK. Now, the next thing we need to do is duplicate this layer. And then go Edit, Transform, Rotate 180 degrees, and we'll have this thing. Now go Edit, free transform, and there are all these things up here. Make sure there is this thing right here and it is checked on, and set the width to 200, and see the width and the height grow together, and that's very good, and click the check thing. Okay, and now we need to go to filter, pixelate, crystallize. Again, the settings are up to you, basically. Just don't do nothing too crazy. Around 15 should be good for this layer, and click OK. But these things are closer to us, and we need to add a blur again, a motion blur, motion blur, and these settings are OK. So that's it. The snowfall. We see there are some snowflakes closer to us and some at the background, and that's pretty good in my opinion. So thank you for watching this tutorial. Bye bye.